Welcome back, and I hope that you had a good and relaxing break. We will now continue with assistant professor from Aarhus University, Finn Jensen, who will talk about educating sustainable electrical engineers. Please, Finn Jensen, go ahead.
Thank you for this, and I'll just share my screen. So, you should all be able to see it now. Okay, my name is Finn Jensen, and I will talk to you about educating sustainable electrical engineers. The word sustainable in this sense has dual meanings, because we want to educate engineers that are sustainable so they can work for many years, but we also want them to work with sustainable issues like this conference we are talking about here. And I'm glad to see that we have at least three of our current students at this conference, and also some former students here. So I'm very pleased to that. It seems that we are doing the right thing on this matter. Okay, I come from Aarhus University, and that is situated about 125 kilometers from Thy. Not that it matters in these corona times, but anyhow, it's on the east coast of Jylland, where Thy is close to the west coast with a lot of wind. Okay, we are organized under the Faculty of Technical Science, where you can study engineering, and there is someone who thought that it would be good to have some kind of a robot visualizing this. Anyhow, that's how it is. Study engineering. We make a Bachelor of Engineering in some different disciplines. The ones I would talk to you today about is the education in electric power technology, or electrical energy technology, as it's called. There's a slight misunderstanding, split of words here. We have one in Aarhus, and we also have a similar one just started in Herning, which is also that. Our engineers are all bachelors, which means that they take 3.5 years of education. I'll come back to that later, the structure of that. But basically, we have 3.5 years Bachelor of Engineering. The course or the education electrical energy technology, that is what we are focusing on here today, and that has a lot to do with sustainable engineers, sustainable energy. What we focus on is the conversion and transport of electrical energy, and we split it into three parts: electrical production, transport and storage of electrical energy, and then finally use of electrical energy. The production is divided into two parts: the central production, which we have known for quite some years now, and this has been replaced or are being replaced by decentral production with a lot of small windmills, big windmills, wind farms also, solar power, and that makes a lot of issues, different problems that we didn't have with the central production, but also a lot of opportunities. So that is what we are focusing on. Also, the transport and storage of electrical energy, that is, of course, we need to have reliable energy supply. We don't want to be without electricity. That is also what we are focusing on. And there is also a lot of issue of safeties that we discussed in the breaks. We will have short circuits. And how do we be sure that they are not dangerous for people or housing or animals? That's also an issue here. And finally, the use of electrical energy. Well, what would it be to produce electrical energy if we didn't use it? So that's, of course, a big issue, to use the electrical energy. But we should use as little as possible, And that is energy savings is something we focus a lot on, and also smart energy usage. So we need to use the energy when it's available and save more and prioritize it so that we don't use energy when it's not available. That is also a big issue. So we take about 110 students per year, about 60 up to 120 students per year. You can take 65 in the autumn and 45 can start in the spring. So we have quite a heavy uptake of students. Yes. The structure of the obligation is that we have 3.5 years of teaching. The first four semesters are basic courses, and then students are in an internship, normally in a company. You can also do it in their own company, but it's normally in a private company where they act like engineers. And then they come back to the campus, and then they do some elective courses and also the bachelor projects. This is how a schedule looks like. And of course, we have a lot of, you can say, standard electrical engineering and mathematics and physics that all engineers should have. But where we will focus on the sustainable energy, sustainable education is on these courses, like the future energy systems and the basics of electrical energy systems and stuff like that. And also on the projects, but also on mainly in the elective courses, which I will come back to later on, is a great heavy on the sustainable issue. But also on the projects, we do a lot of project works. Every semester they do a project, and there's also a lot of sustainable education in that one. And also, of course, in the bachelor projects, I'll come back to that later on. So this is basically where the students are working with sustainable energy in our education. Here's an example of what we can do in the projects. This is our electric car. As you can see, it's actually a go-kart, but the great advantage of this is that it's very maneuverable. You can get access to the motor. You can see the motor. Show it to you. You can see the motor here. And you can see the battery just behind it, and you have the electronics just above it. So this means that we are able to control it very, very, very good in this one. So that is an example of the students working with electric cars and electric transport. Here's another example of a project on third semester. That's about solar panel for rural areas in Africa with green energy, and that was actually presented to the P4G Copenhagen Summit in 2018. That's another example of what we work with. And also here we have work on solar inverter. Behind Kira is a solar inverter, and she's doing some tests on it with short circuit on this one. Well, that is also an example of sustainable energy. And this one is actually, I think I shown it last year at my speech on the second conference last year. This is Daniel, who is in Greenland working on the power supply of radio towers to the left. Yeah, that's another example. It was actually an internship, so that's not a project. But that is some of the examples we do in our education. Okay. We try to put together the courses together with the Sustainable Development Goals, the 17 goals here. And we have actually looked at them and seen that many courses are related to the Sustainable Development Goals. And we can also see that the students are very motivated to this. But we need to have more real life challenges to fulfill the Sustainable Development Goals. And here we have put them into context and see where are we working with those Sustainable Development Goals. Also, as I told you, the students are very motivated for this. We ask them when they start the education, why did you choose electrical energy technology? And the answers are, sorry, it's in Danish, but I'll translate it. Green energy, sustainable, renewable, smart grid. I want to work the whole world, and it's also about future environment. And there's also someone who wanted to work in her father's footsteps. So there's a lot of reasons for choosing. But this shows that the students are motivated to work in this area. Okay. I'll now dive into some of the elective courses we have, which is on the sixth and seventh semester. So that's basically, they are very, very close to become engineers and very close to go out and either work in the field or continue on a master's degree. But they are nearly engineers. We have a range of elective courses and the students can choose from. I'll show you, talk about some of the courses. One of them is actually, well, you can see it's a free course because they can do what they want to if they can talk to the responsible for the course and make a project for him, and he accepted. The one issue is that it should be on one of the 17 Sustainable Development Goals that let's work on, and then they can design their own project or design their own course. So that is actually a sort of project work on the sixth semester, where there normally is not a project work. So that's a freestyle project course here. Another one, which is a fairly new course, we just started it. It's called Energy System Integration. And actually that is a very interesting course because it's actually taking the context of climate change and sustainable energy and look at it together with economics and financing of renewable energy. So it's in the spectrum of hardcore technical science and also looking at energy, finance and economic issues. And also there's a lot of policy planning in that that course. And for that we use the software which is called Homer Energy, which is a tool that is used for simulation of an optimization of microgrid systems in all sectors, that is from small sectors, village power, island utilities, to bigger connected systems. The interesting thing about this is that it's just engineering, but also economics work side by side. So you can take the engineering, the economic aspect into together with the economics and make a simulation system of that one. So that's the energy system integration course. Another course is also, it's an older course, but still very more and more relevant. It's about power quality. And power quality is also an issue where you have frequency inverters, which result in noise on the system. And you also have a lip. a little about the power quality. So you have spikes, surge, sags, noise, and power outage, which we're working on here. So that's where the students will work on these items, so they get familiar with them. And also the energy system stability is also an issue, together with the power quality. Now we have a blackout, which is, of course, we don't want to have a blackout. So we look at power outages, what do they cost and how do we avoid them? What do they cost? And we look at system stability definition. That is, of course, frequency stability and voltage stability. Just jump to that. We also look at introduction to low flow and model for stability calculations and issues like that on a system level. So this was about the elective courses where we have a lot of the items about sustainable energy. And you can look more at this webpage here where we have a more explanation of the elective courses on that one. A bachelor project is also a big issue where we want to have sustainable energy, and I'll just show you some of the bachelor projects. This one is about synchronous reluctance motor parameters and improvement of efficiency by novel control. And this is, of course, on the third item we are talking about in electrical energy, the power consumption, the use of electrical energy, where we want to use as little as possible. Another one is where we're looking at the short circuit power, and that is connection of wind farms to weak AC grids. And this is actually a model of Jylland, where we are. And we have a simulation of different inertia, as was discussed in the break. And we can see what does that mean to the short circuit power if we do that. Another project we would also like to your attention to is we have looked at electrical energy savings on pumps in district heating systems, where we have tried to calculate the energy index based on various models to modify the pumps and to make sure we get the best or the least consumed energy for this one. And also the third one is actually the one I talked to about on the last conference, the isolated DC microgrid solar and wind-powered radio station in Greenland, where we build up a microgrid in simulation, and the project is also converting to the next on this semester, and we were actually very close to put it up in the lab, but this Corona stop the work in the lab, so we will try to build it up in the next semester. I just briefly also mention our lab, because our lab is very, very important in our work. We have a lab that's called Rescue Lab, which is called Renewable Energy System Integration and Control Laboratory under Electrical Engineering. Nobody can remember that, so we just call it the Rescue Lab. It was opened in December 2017, so it's only 4 years, and I will just show you how it looked like in December 2017. Very nice, we're very spacey, and this is how it was half a year ago. Very crowded, very, very many people working on it, and it's very important for us that we have this lab. Because it's good to have we need the engineers to work in the lab, which of course, unfortunately, they cannot do at the moment, but we'll be strongly back to that. Okay. So this is what we work with. I hope you had an overview of how we do teach our engineers to be sustainable, both in sustainable engineers and work with sustainable energy. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Finn. There will be time for very short comments or questions because we are a little bit behind time, but are there any questions right now? It seems not.